Thanks again for coming. Welcome to Enhancing Your Revit Project Experience. And with that, let's head into it. Let's start rolling. Now, as we're looking at things from an introductory standpoint, my name is, as mentioned before, Joachim Sear. I'm the director of the Building Lifecycle Solutions team within Imaginive, which means I get to work with everybody that does anything related to buildings, whether it's design, construction, or facilities management. Matt Mason is joining us to help participate in the Q&A section after the initial presentation, director of our software products division. He's actually the brains behind the outfit, creating everything that's there as far as Clarity is concerned, our tool that we've got called Pulse, all sorts of different products that we've got as Imaginive. So when we're looking at this and rolling it back to the idea of what do we have here as a enhancing your Revit project experience, our purpose in everything that we're talking about here, everything that we'll do, is, as the note says here, to try and do what we can to make BIM coordinators, model managers, whatever the title might happen to be, people that care about what happens to a Revit project, to make your lives a little bit better and to make it easier through, informed information to drive business decisions, task automation, whatever we can manage to pull off. Because as we're looking at it all, we've got a lot of challenges facing us. Even pre-pandemic worlds, we had a lot of constant distractions coming our way. There are places where, trying to find time during the day to get something done is just not happening. There's too much chaos going out there. And there's enough time that we have to spend just getting the immediate fire put out that we don't have a chance to really focus in on strategy, things that are a little bit medium to long-term visions. And as it says, problems are only really recognized as problems once it's become too late. So as we're doing that, then what can we do to help eliminate or reduce the waste of time that is out there? So how much time do you spend making PDFs, extracting DWGs, any other file type that you might think of that you need to produce out of a Revit environment, Navisworks, whatever? How much time do you spend uploading or downloading files or publishing things if you're in the Autodesk Construction Cloud environment? How much time do you spend checking files for standards compliant or this or that? Or how much time do you spend doing these things that they're important enough, they just take a lot of time? So if we have all these things that are going around and we want to enhance your project experience in Revit, we want to do what we can to reduce some of those time sucks. And I'll say let's focus in on four primary areas of what could be things that are happening inside that Revit project environment. And one would be, if we can automate some of those tasks, we'll be that much better off than we would be before. If we can do some things to help out with reports or data sheets or things that are different deliverables that you've got to produce, that'll be good. If there was something that could help out with analyzing your model for its quality, for its health, for its compliance to different key performance indicators that you want to be casting your vision onto. Things that you might be looking for tie into different types of BI tools beyond what might be in the normal Autodesk world of getting into that bigger data thing of Power BI or Tableau or other things. And that gets us into the spot of saving time and money, becoming more efficient, allowing the teams to produce quality work and not pay attention to some of these little things that, well, maybe they're not so little, but you'd really rather spend your time looking somewhere else, understand what's happening more inside that Revit environment. So as a way that this can go through there, imagine it's got a piece of software called Clarity. And our Clarity product, through just the task automation side alone, has saved nearly, we'll say, 1.5 million hours of time for customers, which when you divide it out by the number of projects that these things are working on, averages out to, we'll say, 20 hours per project per month. Or if you've got 10 projects that you can automate to something, you can free up time equivalent to a full-time employee equivalent, one FTE. So there's huge things that are possible through here. And that's just with the idea of task automation, let alone what you might be able to pull off from different types of business intelligence. And the list goes on from those four quadrants that we saw earlier. Now, in the Clarity case specifically, there's a lot of things that we can do to help out with that idea of task automation, whether it's automating the process of printing and exporting different elements from your Revit files or AutoCAD files for that matter, for different aspects of collaboration. I mean, there's just a whole slew of things that are possible. Your typical PDFs, for example, everybody does PDFs. Does it take 5 minutes to produce a PDF set? Does it take 3 hours? Does it take, one of our customers takes 12 hours to produce a PDF set of the entire project. That's time that if we can get some other system to help automate and run that for you, it's just pulling that time in to save your time and effort and energy. If we go beyond those types of categories into different things we can do to understand the data of what's happening in or around your Revit files for health, quality, business intelligence, you name it, to be able to go through and manage things better. There's a number of our customers that just want to have a local backup copy of things that they've got in the cloud, whichever cloud environment it might happen to be, but to keep those local backups, to synchronize between different cloud environments, to go ahead and maybe create some custom tasks through Dynamo, PyRevit, or formal programming to create your own things. All of those pieces, just things that we can do to save your slice of that nearly 1.5 million hours of time that we're already saving our customers. If we're pulling out data, being able to turn that into different types of reports, timelines, dashboards, to be able to understand what's happening inside the different models that you have, to understand what are the KPIs you care about. Do you care about the number of in-place families? Do you care about warnings? Do you care about file size? Do you care about file open time? Find the ones that you care about and let the system start managing it for you, and then start seeing where you line up with other people in the building design environment, to be able to generate reports or data sheets based off of the data from those Revit models to get into the things that tend to matter. Now, this is being that Clarity software, what does something like this look like? Well, that's a screen cap from what would be there from an iPad or some sort of a mobile device look in. But the other thing is, keep it easy. If we've got a system like this from a Clarity standpoint, I can say, let's go into a retirement center. And from that retirement center, I want to create PDFs. I can say, great, let's create PDFs. And as I'm doing this, the background system is going to be creating those. My computer is never going to launch Revit. I don't even have to have Revit installed. That's why I can launch a task from an iPad or a phone, because that other system's taking care of things for me. Once those items are done, maybe we're pulling off data and identifying what metrics do we care about. Simple red, green, yellow dots that'll tell us what's the quality of the Revit files. Now, obviously here, I've got a bunch of things that probably need a little bit of work to get them back on track. It'd be nice to get all green dots all the way across, to be able to understand how across time have these things been changing. If I'm looking at various reports, to be able to understand from a reporting standpoint, it's simple, a door schedule. We'll pull open that information, be able to see, here's where all of those doors are on this level of the building. If I want to, I could go ahead and show a diagram. And in the basement, I've just got these three doors, that's the attic. If I go to the main floor level, I've got doors in all these locations. Maybe start to color code those based off of the family or the type or manufacturer to understand what's happening in the model. And you've got all these things that you can do with no need to do anything other than know how to browse a web portal. Keep it simple, keep it easy, keep it rolling. Now, from that spot, if we're looking at those types of things and what we can do from a data delivery standpoint, from a data analysis standpoint to wherever we're going next, one thing to note from a Clarity software standpoint, we've got a little bit of a stack here for what it is, what it does. There's an initial piece of the Clarity-based software, but then some extra modules that can add on to it, whether we need to integrate with Bentley ProjectWise, to integrate with a new space programming module that we just came out with, to reskin it to be a little bit more appropriate for somebody that's on an owner's side and wanting to look at reports to see things in a different way than somebody that might be a building designer, building engineer cares about. So that is 10 minutes, super fast, of what is something that we can use out there to help out with improving your overall quality of life, your Revit project experience. I appreciate your time here. Hope to see you back at our booth, or if need be, feel free to reach out to us through email, head to our website, and have a great rest of your Autodesk University.
All right. Thanks, everybody.
See ya.